April 1979. In the docks of General Dynamics in Groton, Connecticut, officials gathered for a momentous event, the launch of a submarine that would go down in naval history. At 170 meters long, 558 feet, and displacing 18,750 tons, it was the largest submarine ever built in America. A steel Leviathan armed with enough firepower to erase an entire nation. USS Ohio, the first of 18 nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. A new foundation for America's nuclear triad. Even today, more than four decades later, these vessels remain engineering marvels. It all began in the mid-1960s, the height of the space race between the US and the Soviet Union. While rockets were launching astronauts into orbit, a parallel arms race was unfolding beneath the surface. The emergence of intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, had destabilized the strategic balance. For the first time, Soviet missiles could hit American air bases and launch silos before the US could retaliate. In response, the Pentagon launched a major study known as STRAT-X, aiming to modernize all three legs of the US nuclear triad: land, air, and sea. The result was 9 forward-looking strategic concepts, 4 of which were naval. One of them proposed a fleet of large submarines capable of carrying long-range missiles and patrolling undetected anywhere on the planet. This vision would become reality in two parts: a new ballistic missile and a new class of submarine. In the early 1970s, development began on a missile with greater range and payload than anything in the US arsenal. That missile was Trident, and it met all expectations. Meanwhile, naval engineers calculated that an optimal submarine should carry around 20 missiles, which implied a vessel displacing roughly 14,000 tons. As development progressed, the subs grew heavier and deadlier. General Dynamics was selected as the prime contractor, and its electric boat shipyard was heavily modified for the task. The lead vessel was laid down in 1976 and named after the state of Ohio. The class would bear the same name. Initially, the U.S. Navy planned for 10 of these submarines, but as construction advanced, so did strategic ambition. By the time USS Ohio was commissioned in 1981, the Navy had expanded its order to 15 boats, and eventually to 18. From 1981 to 1997, General Dynamics delivered all 18 Ohio-class submarines to the U.S. Navy fleet. Designing them was a monumental engineering challenge, combining size, endurance, stealth, survivability, and affordability. After all, even the Pentagon has a budget. These submarines, part of the U.S. Navy's third-generation strategic deterrent, set American records. At 170 meters long, 558 feet, and displacing nearly 18,750 tons submerged, they were massive, but not the largest in the world. That title belongs to the Soviet Akula-class submarines, NATO-class Typhoon, which reached a staggering 48,000 tons. Still, the Ohios hold a different record. Firepower. Each submarine is equipped with 24 vertical launch tubes for ballistic missiles, even more than the Typhoon's 20. This was possible thanks to the relatively compact and lightweight Trident missiles. The first 8 submarines were armed with Trident 1C4 missiles. These 33-ton missiles had a range of 7,400 kilometers, 4,600 miles, and carried up to 8 W-76 warheads, each with a yield of 100 kilotons. Starting with the 9th boat, USS Tennessee, the Navy switched to Trident 2D5 missiles, with an extended range of 12,000 kilometers, 7,500 miles. These could carry up to 8 W-88 warheads, 475 kilotons each, or up to 14 of the smaller W-76. The missiles can be launched from a depth of 30 meters, 100 feet, at low speed and in sea conditions up to sea state 6, meaning waves of 4 to 6 meters. Theoretically, all 24 missiles can be launched within minutes. But in practice, such a salvo has never been attempted and would be prohibitively expensive. Of course, even a ballistic missile sub needs torpedoes. The Ohios are armed with 4 torpedo tubes, typically loaded with Mark 48 heavyweight torpedoes for self-defense. Structurally, these boats use a hybrid hull design. The inner pressure hull, where the crew and systems are housed, is made of high-strength steel with full-length reinforcing ribs. Above it sits a partial outer hull, which covers the missile compartment and reduces hydrodynamic noise. This configuration classifies the design as a hybrid single hull. The sail is tall and narrow, positioned forward of the missile section, and includes horizontal diving planes. At the stern, cruciform control surfaces, with large vertical rudders, help maneuver the submarine. Their test depth is around 240 meters, 790 feet. Propulsion is nuclear. Each boat is powered by a General Electric S8G pressurized water reactor, producing 240 megawatts, which drives two 35,000 horsepower steam turbines connected to a single screw propeller with 7 or 8 swept back blades. The propeller's design remains classified. Backup diesel generators and auxiliary power units provide redundancy and onboard system support. Maximum submerged speed is around 25 knots. Perhaps the most impressive feature of the Ohio class is their stealth. Enormous efforts were made to minimize their acoustic signatures. The propulsion system was completely redesigned, multiple quiet operating modes were introduced, and the hull was carefully shaped to reduce hydrodynamic noise. In the early 1980s, the results were astonishing. During naval exercises, contemporary sonar systems often failed to detect them at all. And even today, more than 4 decades later, their stealth capabilities are still considered exceptional, a testament to the engineering brilliance behind their design. These submarines remain among the quietest in the world. The submarines are equipped with a sophisticated suite of sonar and electronic systems. The original sonar suite, ANBQQ6, used a massive 4.5-meter spherical array with nearly 1,000 hydrophones. Later boats, and earlier ones through upgrades, received the more modern ANBQQ10 with open architecture to support further enhancements. These subs can create hydrographic maps and share tactical data with the rest of the fleet. Their patrol zones span the Pacific and Atlantic. 2 naval bases support their operations: Naval Base Kitsap near Seattle for Pacific patrols, and Kings Bay in Georgia for Atlantic operations. Each base has full maintenance, training, and support infrastructure. Each submarine is assigned 2 full crews of 150 personnel each, the Blue and the Gold. These crews rotate on and off duty, allowing the submarine to spend more time at sea without overworking personnel. While one crew is on patrol, the other rests, trains, or prepares for the next deployment. An Ohio-class submarine typically patrols a designated area, roughly 200 by 200 nautical miles, silently gathering intelligence and staying deep beneath the waves, unseen and unheard. These submarines are built to avoid direct confrontation. They don't go looking for a fight. Stealth and deterrence are their primary missions. But from time to time, unexpected situations arise, rare moments when a submarine must break cover and reveal itself. One such moment came in 2009. A small fishing vessel had capsized in the Caribbean, leaving 5 people stranded in a lifeboat, far from any shipping lanes, with no communication and little hope of rescue after 4 days adrift. Then, against all odds, they were spotted by none other than the USS Rhode Island, a nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine on a classified patrol. Faced with a human emergency, the submarine's crew made a rare and deliberate decision: to break their cloak of invisibility, surface, and rescue the fishermen. A vessel designed for nuclear deterrence, silent, secretive, and hidden in the depths, rose to the surface not for war, but to save lives. A moment of unexpected humanity in a machine built for Armageddon. Ironically, the fall of the Soviet Union created a problem for the Ohio-class fleet. No peer adversary remained. Ambitions to build 24 boats were scrapped. Arms reduction treaties called for a maximum of 14 strategic missile subs. In fact, Pentagon assessments concluded that only 4 were needed to maintain effective nuclear deterrence. The first 8 boats, initially armed with outdated Trident Muffin missiles, were in danger of early retirement. Instead, 4 were upgraded to carry Trident 2D5 missiles. The other 4 were converted to guided missile submarines, SSGNs, capable of launching conventional strikes. In place of 24 missile tubes, 22 were reconfigured with canisters holding 7 Tomahawk cruise missiles each, for a total of 154 cruise missiles. The remaining 2 tubes were modified to support special operations gear. Because these converted boats no longer carried strategic nuclear weapons, they did not count toward treaty limits, and became some of the most cost-effective multi-role platforms in the Navy. Today, the 14 remaining Ohio-class SSBNs carry approximately 2,100 warheads, nearly 60% of the U.S. deployed nuclear arsenal. As of 2021, all 18 boats remained active. Despite being over 40 years old, they still perform patrols lasting up to 6 months. Their replacements are already under construction. Beginning in 2029, the Ohios will be gradually retired and replaced by a new class, the Columbia-class strategic submarine. And so the story of America's silent sentinels goes on, unseen but always ready. What do you think about these nuclear behemoths? Let us know in the comments below. Subscribe, hit like, or even dislike. It all helps the channel grow. And as always, stay curious.